cat needed food, it required either 300 prayer points or over 1k sharks per whip drop from the oh so great ones rubbing their whips in our faces. I was getting really irritated about how long this has taken us, and came to a brilliant idea. Extranormal. My god, no way. Cass was fishing her sharks, and I was pounding on Addy when it hit me. Are my dreams becoming even more real to you now? Are you feeling my ethics and determination, and finding out what this silly, never going to happen spell means to me? By the time I got my whip, extract had already maxed once, and the whips had dropped to 12 mil. Still not bad considering I had only played RS for less than 8 months, and had 80 plus mining and smithing. Ta-da, Magic had won the first major battle in all of his RS history. I still have that whip Cass gave me, and will never sell it, ever. Why don't you think I have 85 Slayer by now? Because my whip was one of the first 100 dropped, we're guessing, and I don't ever want it mixed in with one of those, no legend behind, generic 1.8 to 2.1 mil hunts of junk. My entire faith system in this game, stemming from obtaining an insignificant item, how sad. If that root of evil didn't rear its ugly face and start making accusations, everything would have been fine. But now all of a sudden it wasn't anymore. All of my glory, I felt, was squashed in one simple click. As my reader, after everything I just told you about how I work to make others happy and achieve their dreams, yet still filling in my own pages of RS history along the way. How long could you have sustained not ever making a nickel? Losing everything you had before, a successful RS business, and dozens of out-of-touch friends I miss so dearly? What was all this worth? Definitely not just a whip, I did it because I wanted to. But now all of a sudden, since I declined to continue any farther, I was being selfish, and proved how greedy I really was. Is this how you're seeing me? W. L. Somebody did, and I won't ever let something like that happen again. Ever. The blood splattered on the cave walls set the perimeters of our agreement. I have no guilty conscience about it whatsoever. Okay, maybe I do feel some type of way about it, utter disappointment. How could somebody have just deleted me after everything had I done for them? My little fire I had, that Thor had sparked months before, now engulfed into a four-alarm, all men on duty, pyroclasm. Extract is going to be my final gift to this person, unless they ever read this, and feel remorse for all my anguish. It takes Alad to be the best player in this game. Alad of what I don't have instilled in my veins, or in this account. But what I do have, is the knowledge I always try my best, at no matter what I do. Stop the presses, folks, Magic the Prick is not here to compete. My goal is to learn and share, and be the best I can be, that's it. I'm not stepping on anyone's toes, and I surely won't ever expect anyone to ever do something for me free of charge. There's a few other old friends out there that need to understand this too. Like this one woman I met when we were aimlessly searching for the Earth Altar. Yet, like a fox, I remember names and faces that make a good impression on me. Oh no, not in combat, nope, not total levels either. That's why this thread is wide open to anyone that wants to join. It's people's personalities I yearn to seek. Aren't we all human? You can crown a prince, but that doesn't ever mean he didn't get bumped of the cart in the ghetto and raised by animals. Only to be later returned to where he belongs, then be misunderstood. Simply by his status. It's a cruel world, one that's been etched into my tablets of fortune, that those so long to seek in this game. Beware.